Hello friend, my name is Shivam Shivare and welcome to our channel Instructor's Point. So today we all got the email from the invitation from NCR Code Wars 2020. So this is the practice test for the NCR which was going on from 2nd of October to 5th of October. So there is a practice test. So now we will go and check what type of code and what type of programming MCQs comes there. So now I will agree all the condition here. So this is the test which is duration is 45 minutes here. Okay, so these are the instructions. Ensure that your mail ID is correct and click submit on to the button. Okay, so they are allowed programming language C#, C++, C++14, Java and Java 8 edition. There is two objective and one programming. Okay, one coding. Okay, so now we will enter into the code. So now we are entering the test. So there is a timer. You can start solving problems in 56 seconds. Okay. So these are the test instructions. So we read carefully. Duration of this test is 45 minutes. Okay. You can attempt this test multiple times if you want. You can pause while attempting the test. Okay. Close all other windows tabs. Okay. So there is a select a programming language from the list before the attempting each questions. Okay, so for all programming problems the input are taken from stdin and output to stdout. Okay, so now friends we will check to click compile and test to run your solutions against relevant sample test cases. Submitting your answers, this is applicable for programming questions only. Okay, so there are two MCQs and one coding question here. Okay, so we will enter into the test after two seconds. Okay, now we will enter start test. So here we can see that there is a two multiple choice question and one programming question, and the time is start now 43 minutes and 46 seconds. Okay, so there is a question, which of these is an expression for runtime in TN for the following recurrence. Okay, so TN is equals to 4T and this is multiplication product of N by 2 plus N to the power 2. Okay, so this is the case of Master's theorem. Okay, so there is a four. So Master's theorem says that TN is equals to AT and there is AT N divided by B plus N to the power 2 here. Okay, so the Master's theorem says that TN is equals to AT N to the N by B plus F of N. So here F of N is N to the power 2. Okay, and A is what? A is 4 here. And B is what? B is 2 here. So the according to the Master's theorem, it follows that T, if TN is equals to A to A, AT N by B plus F of N. So it means that it is the recurrence of this question is big O N square log N. Okay. So big O N square log N. Okay. So this is the answer for this question. So now we submit and time to the next. Okay. So now there is a question, in data structure, which of the following methods is used to return the value of the top of a stack without removing any object, without removing any object. So pop is basically do what? Pop is, if we perform the pop operation, so it will remove the element from the stack. Okay. So if suppose there is an five element and we perform and pop operation, so it will remove one element therefrom. So now the now in stack there is only four elements. Okay, for peak is an operation on certain abstract data types, so such as stacks and queues, which returns the value of the top of the collection without removing the element from the collection. Okay, so peak is the right answer for this because of the in the question the top of the stack without removing any object. So the peak is the right answer for this question. Last is nothing and empty is checked whether the stack is empty or not. So we submit the peak option. Okay, now submit the question and go to the next question. Okay, so now there is an one programming question. So here we have to pass the all test cases. So the question is, write a program to find the minimum number in a list of a given n integers. So there is an input format. First line contain number of integer n. So here we will pass and enter the number from the user. Okay, and second line check contains n number separated by single space. It means that if there is a number n, so there are second line contains n number separated by single space. So the output format is print the minimum number in n given integers. Means that if I will give the input is 3 and I will pass 3 elements 1, 4, 5. So which is the minimum number of in these 3 numbers? So 1 is the minimum number. Okay, so there is an input constraint. 1 is less than equals to n as less than equals to 10. Okay, and 1 is less than equals to a of I and less than equals to 100 there. Okay, so there is a simple input. If first line contain n integer, so first line contain 3 integer, so the value of n is 3 here. Second line contains n number separated by single space. Okay, it means that 5, 1, 4, these are the 3 elements, 3 numbers input by the user. So which of these are minimum? So the 1 is the minimum number, so the output is minimum here. So 1 is the minimum integer among the given numbers. Okay, so time limit is 1 second for each input and there is memory limit is 256 MB, source limit is this, and these are the following languages. So we will have to compile our code in C++. So okay, if you know C sharp, Java, Java 8, C++ also, so you can do it here. Okay, so now we will code here. Okay, now remove these all things. Firstly, we include the header, which is IOStream in C++, and here we take using namespace standard. So here you can see that we are taking an header file which is IOStream and taking using namespace standard. If you find some using namespace standard means that you have to find something that is not declared in the current scope and go check standard using namespace standard are used. It is because computer needs to know the code for C out, C in functionalities, and it needs to know. So we use using namespace standard. Okay. So now we will take some variable, and now firstly we declare the main function here. Okay. So now we declare the main function. Okay. And after declaring the main function, we have to take some array which will hold the data, like as I have to pass a of 5. Here, because of that n number of integer we have to pass. Okay, now I will take some variable like int n. The user will give the input n, and I is used for for loop condition, and there is a min value. Okay, now here we don't write c out here, because of that we have to get the output in this form. Okay, so now directly we will say to the user to input a number, so c in n. Okay, so now the user will get the number of integer, like as there is a 5. Okay, so now we will create a loop. I is assigned with initially it's 0, and I will up to n. Okay, and now it will iterate i++. Okay, now we'll go enter into the for loop. So now c in a of I, it means that elements comes under this array of I. Okay, so like if someone input there is 3, so the elements come after 3 is 1, 2, 5, so these elements comes under this cn. Okay, and it comes under this for loop. Okay, now we will assign the value of a 0 initially, element of the array are asked to enter and stored in A using a for loop. Okay, the value at index 0 of array is assigned to variable min here. Okay. And if now again we create a for loop, it will check the condition for minimum number of element, which is the minimum number of element. Okay. I is 0 here again, and I is up to run up to n, like there is 5. So I initially it's 0 and I is less than n, so I is less than 5 here. Okay, so now again iterate I plus plus entering into the loop. Now if we check the condition, if min value is greater than k of I, okay, then the value of a of I will assign in min variable. Okay, and now after the condition is false, so it will comes out from the for loop and it will print the result. Okay, so C out is in to print the result. C is min here. Okay, and now we return 0 here. Okay, means that there is an function, the user is initially asked to enter the size of array and it is stored in the variable n here. Okay, an array of data type integer is declared with the size a of 5. Okay, and the constraint is here less than equals to 10. Okay, not more than this. Now the value element the array are asked to enter and stored in a using a for loop. Okay, now it will be stored in a variable a, which is of array type. Okay, now the value of index 0 of a is assigned to the variable min. Okay, here the loop can now entering into the loop, and after a of i here is like n is 5 here, so element of a of I is 1 space 5 space 6 space 4 and 6. So these are the elements comes under this. Okay, now remove this. So now it will check the condition. The loop will continue till I is less than n. Similarly, the smallest element is found. The value at index 0 of array is assigned to the variable min. And here we can see that our code is now ready. And now we will compile and test our test cases. So here we can see that sample test case is passed. And now we will submit the final result here. Okay, so we see that there is a result accepted and we pass all the test cases here and the input is 3514 and the minimum number is 1 here. Okay, so this is the code for NCR Corporation practice test, and I hope you will understand all the steps over this code, and I hope you would like this video and share with your friend, and thank you, and please comment and subscribe our channel. Thank you.